Hello there, Miss Sigourney. This is Bella Jackson, the letting agent for Latrine Cottage. Sorry I missed your call this morning. I just wanted to let you know that Jim the neighbour has prepared the accommodation for your visit and the keys will be behind the Ganesh statue by the front door. I have left some food and drink in the refrigerator for when you arrive. Should you need it, please help yourself. Sometimes the satellite navigation doesn't work too well in those parts, so if you take the B4218 out of Great Malvern towards Upper Wych, that will lead to Welwyn Road. Follow the Welwyn Road until you reach Colwell Stone and then turn onto Mill Lane and that will take you to Colwell. From Colwell, turn onto Flapgate Lane and follow it for about a mile and you'll come to a narrow track that veers off to the left. You will see a sign that says Latrine Cottage there. It's about 300 yards along the track. It sounds complicated, but it's pretty straightforward. I'll be out of the country for a few weeks, but if you need to contact me, please send me an email and I'll get back to you within a couple of hours. The Wi-Fi connection can be a little temperamental up there, but it's usually not too bad. I'm sure you'll find the cottage extremely pleasant. The Malvern Hills are beautiful in the spring. If you go walking in the woods near the cottage, take care to remember your way back and stick to the main paths. It's like a maze in there. Do try to avoid them after nightfall. Well, once again, thank you for choosing Latrine Cottage and I wish you an enjoyable stay. Please try the juicy apples. They are most delicious.
No signal. Great.
Thank you. Well, you have come back again. You always did come back, didn't you? You came back again and again and again. You came back all those times to your Uncle John. Time and time again. But then you spoiled the game by telling Mummy and getting Uncle John sent away. I've been waiting for you. I knew you would come back when your mummy died in a car accident. Oh, that Zobaden. And your poor brother burnt to a crisp in the wreckage. He used to love his camera. He liked filming Uncle John with it. Yes, he did. He used to love that. Let's play those games we used to play. All those years ago. Come on, don't be shy. Your Uncle John has waited so very, very long. Let's play those games we used to play all those years ago.
This place is going to be a bundle of fun.
I have left some food and drink in the refrigerator for when you arrive. Should you need it, please help yourself.
You like filming Uncle-chan with it? Yes, you did.
Hi, Ruth. It's Nancy.
Hey.
Well, I got here.
Lindsay, how is the place then?
Well, yeah, it's okay, I suppose.
You don't sound too sure.
To be honest, I don't know. I'm not so sure this was a good idea coming out here all by myself.
Is it as nice as the photos made it out to
be? There's something not quite right about this place. It's this strange vibe about it.
Oh, come on, Lindsay. You know you needed a break after losing your mum. Some time to get your head together.
I had a really strange experience on the way up here.
Okay, go on.
Well, the car started having problems in the middle of nowhere, and it stalled. I couldn't get it to start. But listen, get this.
What?
A figure appeared from nowhere behind a car. Can you believe that?
What? You mean like the bogeyman?
Yeah, now you come to mention it, it looked all disfigured, like it was burned or something. It, like, literally, its face was completely distorted, and it was wearing this long green coat.
Go on.
But the weird thing was, I could only see it in a reversing camera. Can you imagine?
What?
Like, when I looked behind the car and when I looked in the rear view mirror, I couldn't see. I couldn't see anything. It was so weird.
Come on, Linacy. It was probably some country yokel.
No, Ruth. It didn't look human. And then it started moving closer to the car.
What?
You know, I managed to get it to start and get away, but it scared the hell out of me. And then when I arrived here, I thought I saw it again across the field.
Can I relax and unwind? If
Ruth?
You want.
Ruth?
Okay.
Hello? Hello? Oh, great.
My
They told me a visitor would be coming up here this week. And they asked me to come over to make sure everything's okay and if you needed anything. I prepared the cottage for you, ma'am. I live in a cottage just the other side of the woods there. I found this by the side of your car. I think you must have dropped it.
No, it's not mine. It must belong to the owners.
Oh, but it can't be. The owner is in Jalandhar at the moment. India.
I know. Mrs. Jackson told me she would be away. Well, thank you for popping by and getting the cottage ready. But I really must go. I've got a pizza in the oven.
Pizza? Oh, Mummy, I do love a piece of pizza.
Mr. Jameson, did you put that stuff in the fridge?
Stuff in the fridge?
Yes. Thank you.
I suppose I'll be off before it gets dark. These woods can be very deceptive at night, you know. The appearance of things can change in the darkness. Even familiar, inanimate objects can become, well, unfamiliar. I've known these woods here for many a year, but even I get lost from time to time, especially at night. Don't go walking in here after dark, young lady. You might get lost. If you need anything during your stay, you can call me. If the telephone is working. You can find my number in the book on the telephone stand. It's Jameson, Jim Jameson. If you need anything, anything at all, please call me. You won't be disappointed. Do you remember me?
God, I'm becoming like my mother. Like my mother, I'm becoming.
Oh, that Zobadon. I've been waiting for you.
With this place. This is too much. I have to get out right now.
She wasn't disappointed, Mummy.
To a crisp in the wreckage.